Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to make this super awesome origami block. This is an origami flower, as you can see it's 3D, and I've made it into a lovely block that you can put on cushions, you can add onto a quilt, it's entirely up to you. So let's not mess around, let's get straight into the demonstration. So the first thing we want to do is cut a 10-inch square out of our main fabric that we're going to be making the flower from. So let's just neaten this up a bit. So 10 inches, excuse me if you can't see that for a second, but I just want to make sure that I'm accurate. 10 inches. Okay, so starting with our accent block, I'm not sure that's 10 inches square, so let me just double check that. It's not. There we are. Okay, there, now we've got a 10 inch block. So starting with that, we're going to bring in our pressing mat. The great thing about this is it works really well on the 12 by 12 mat as well, because it's a 10 inch block, so it fits perfectly. So now what we're going to do is make sure we've got our iron heated up, or heating up, I should say. And we're going to fold the bottom to the top. And then we're going to press all along that line. Just give it a nice press, make sure it's accurate. Okay, like so. Now we want to open this up and then we're going to fold it left to right. And we're going to press this line, but what you don't want to do is get rid of the line you've pressed here. So just make sure you're pressing up to the point and on this side as well, because you don't want to go over the line you've already pressed. Just right up to that point. Okay. So now when you open that up, you've got an X. Now you want to take each corner and fold it into the centre, like this, and press as well. So there's that one. And onto the next one. Make sure you're pressing. This is really key. This is why having a pressing mat is such a great thing, because you can do this anyway, you're not restricted to where you can make these. So again, and you can see how wonderfully flat this presses. You can just have a regular iron, you don't need one of these small irons. Right, now we're going to flip this over, making sure that all stays in place. And if it doesn't, just simply tuck it back under, you know, that's absolutely fine. Just make sure everything is where it should be, and it is. Now we're going to take one side and we're going to fold it up to the centre. So this is one of the bottom edges. And we're going to press. Okay. And then we're going to repeat that on the other side. So they meet in the centre. Press. Make sure you've got a really good line. And go back to the other side if you want to, you're not limited. Right, open those out. So now you should see all sorts of lines. So now what you're going to do is you're going to take the two sides. Oh no, no. Now what you're going to do is do the same again. So from top to bottom. So we've done the sides, now we're doing top to bottom. And press. And the other side. And press. We've got all sorts of lines going on now, which is exactly what we want. Okay, so now when we open this up, we need some pins. Then what we want to do is fold along these two lines. So we're folding this one over. We want to flop that back. Then fold this one over. So that they meet in the centre, but we've got this gapage here. Then we're just going to pin that into place. Oop. Bit fiddly. Okay. And you can let that flop to one side, that's fine. And we're gonna repeat it for all four sides. So open this side out, fold this side in. And what I do is I have that one then facing upwards like this, and then we're just gonna pin it into place. So you can use the same pin, or you'll end up with four pins, up to you. Next side, open it out, fold it over, and then you've got another ear. And I'll probably use the same pin here. So just carefully unpin that one. And then you've got your final one. So just tuck that one out of the way. You've got your final one here that's already done for you because you've done the others. So what you'll do is you'll end up with a sort of pinwheel effect, okay? Okay, so now you need to get some thread because you're going to stitch these together ever so slightly in the center. Now, if you don't like the look of the stitch, you can put a button or something in there. You don't have to have the stitches showing. So just a nice corresponding thread, or matching thread, I should say. And you're just gonna put a stitch in at each 4 points. So 1, 2, 3, 4, just to secure them. Now, if anything comes undone, like this, you can always open up and start again. So nothing here is undoable. So as we did before, folding one in, folding the other one in. Now, if you don't like to pin, you can stitch. So just making sure that's flat, making sure everything's as it should be. And joining that in. And I'm gonna just do a little stitch to join them together and take it through. Just a little top stitch. Okay, then repeating on the other side, just mind your thread out the way. So you've got your one and then your second one. And because you've got all those folds already, it just sort of naturally falls into place. So another tack. Be careful not to pull too much because you want to make sure that everything is as it should be underneath. And again, next one. Little tacking stitch and through to the other one as well because that's naturally formed. And just a little tie off. You do want to make sure this is secure. You don't want this coming undone. Little knot and a snip. Now let's just pop those out of the way. Now the great thing with the pressing mat is you can just pin directly into it. Right, so now we've got our four as we had before as a pinwheel, but now they're secured with the thread. So now what we can do is unfold the back pieces, like so. And the last one that I've managed to tuck away. So we've unfolded the back pieces and we're going to flip over. So at the back, you will have a square in the centre of your other square. Okay, then flipping back over, you're going to now open out your flowers. You're going to have it folded like this. Now what I do is I bring it into the center and I give it a press. And then I hold the top and I pull it out. And then tuck those in and that's your first petal. I'll repeat that in case you didn't see. So we flipped around back to the front that we were working on. And this is our petal. We're going to open it out. Fold it in, again, because you've got those creases, this will be really easy. It looks complicated, but you've creased it already. You've done the hard work. And then you're going to flatten it out like this. Okay, moving on to the next one. Flattening it out, minding your fingers. Opening it out. Let's give it a little press. And then the last one, press and open it out. Really is quite beautiful. So what you want to make sure is when you're doing all your folds that your edges, your points meet up really well, because as you can see here, this one isn't lined up quite well, and that means I've got a little rough edge there. For the purpose of this, I'm not overly bothered, but this one is much better. So now you've got your block. So what you can do, let me lift this up to show you. There's your block, there's your flower. What you can do now is fold those back in themselves and just pin them down. And then you can build up your block around this so that then when you open everything out, you've got this beautiful flower in the center, like so. So what we're gonna do is mind everything to one side. And the reason why I start with a center block is because things can go wrong. Things can, you know, we might go a little haywire. So we like to end up with this block and then we'll build around it. So now we're going to measure this. So that is 4¾ inches. What I am going to do is just press it again, just to make sure everything is lined up. I'm going to pin these petals into place so that they don't get caught in any seams when I'm building up around it. But you're fine to catch this side. I hope that makes sense. So if you haven't done it quite accurately, your block will be a bit wonky, but that's nothing that can't be fixed with your blocks. So just manipulate your edges and press those well. Okay. So now we're gonna make a block around this. So we want to cut four rectangles that are 4¾ inches long, because they're gonna just butt up against there. And we want them to be about 3 inches in width, probably more like 2¾ inches. Because of the what we're working with. So I'm just gonna cut a little bit of this off so it's a bit easier for me to manage for demonstration. So getting my ruler and my rotary cutter. So what did we say, 4¾ inches. So let's just neaten up this edge. Inches cut. I think I need to change the blade on my rotary cutter. 4¾ inches. Right, so 4¾ inches, and then probably the width we want to do, I would say, having looked at it now, let's go for 3 inches. And we want four of these because there's four edges. So we've got three there and our four. Just snip those off. So there's our four that we've got, and we're going to now place. So let's have a look what this looks like with those at the edges. Yeah, really happy with that. So now I need squares to fill here. So the size that we did here, which was 3 inches, these are going to be 3-inch blocks either side. So we need to cut out 4 3-inch blocks in another colour. So we'll use this lovely turquoise. It actually does need a bit of a press. So we'll press that before we cut it so that we're accurate with our cutting. bring an iron. Get that nice and prepared for cutting. What a lovely shade of blue. Really beautiful. Okay, that will do for now. Pop my mat away again. So we need 3-inch strips so that we can make our 3-inch blocks. So using my ruler, 1, 2, 3. And 1, 2, 3. Pop that bit to one side. Turn it round, make sure this edge is straight, which it's slightly off. We'll just trim the end. And then we want 4 3-inch blocks. So 1, 2, 3. One, two, three. One, two, three. Oopsies. And then just one more with the other strip that we cut. One, two, three. So let's place this out again and we'll have another look. So those are going to be either side. That's going to be there. That's going to be there. And then we'll place these blocks like that. Really, really pretty. I do think we could probably do a bit more here. We could make this into a sawtooth block. To make it into a sawtooth block, what we would do is, so this length here, what did we say that was? 4 3/4. What you would do is cut 2 squares that would fit over this. So 4 3/4, that's 2, what is that? I'm so rubbish at maths. 4 3/4, 3/4, whatever that is. 4 3/4 divided by 2, you're gonna then cut 2 blocks. You'd cut, place the square over the top, stitch along the edge, fold it back, and then you can cut off the excess. That's a really easy way of making a sawtooth block. So maybe let's give that a go. Obviously, I've just said my maths is quite atrocious, so we'll use one of these pieces as a guide. I'm going to measure 3 inches. This really does need a new blade. Okay, now let's trim those down to 3 inches again, just neatening off the end, like so. Using our ruler again to measure 3 inches. 1, 2, 3, 4. On to the next one. 5, 6, 7. And the final one, 8. Okay, so now taking one of our side pieces, we're going to place side to side our square. We're going to come in 1/4 inch. So when we stitch, that 1/4 inch will line up perfectly with the bottom of our design, and we will have a lovely sawtooth block. So bring the machine, you can pin this if you want to. Like so, and then coming in 1/4 inch away from the edge. And you're gonna stitch down 1/4 inch away from the other point. So then when we open this out, we've got the start of our sawtooth block. And we're going to do the same on the other side. But you want to trim off your excess first. So you can use scissors or you can use your rotary cutter. Just make sure you're trimming the right side. Then you want to open this out, finger press, take your other block, line up your edge like we did before, and you're going to go again quarter of an inch away from the edge, all the way to the bottom. Like so. Then when you open that out, you'll have a beautiful block. So let's trim off all our excess. Okay, we're going to bring in our pressing mat and we're going to set the seams. So that just means running over the seams with your iron and then opening it out and doing the same on the other side. Okay, now what you do is you just simply, I'm going to leave this bulk on here because that's going to be the edge that I stitch against here, so you can see that there. You can trim off any extra here if you want to, you don't have to. So let's just do that with the next one. So we've got three more to go. I'm going to press these open. One, done that one already. Two. Four. I'm going to replace these against our block. We can have them going in like this, like that. And then we'll use our squares here to create the rest of the piece. So taking one of our blocks, we're going to attach a square here and a square here. Open that out. And then one on the other side. Now, obviously, you'll be able to do this a lot prettier than I'm doing because I'm rushing. So there's our first strip. Our second strip is actually going to be our block. So we want to place these right sides together and stitch. The other side, we're going to do the same. And then our final block is going to be one of these, two squares either side, making sure that needle is up. On the other side. Again, yours will be a lot neater than this. Now you want to press these. Make sure it's pressed really well. And that centre one. Then we're going to join the top to here. Now this is where my block wasn't overly accurate. I'm just going to manipulate that ever so slightly so that I can attach this on. grab a pin. So this is where I'm really interested in getting it completely right. And then taking it to the machine, making sure those edges, those seams are lined up nicely. Opening that out, double checking. Yep, looks good. Other side, again, just making sure that the triangles are facing the right way. Lining up those seams. Obviously, this is a bit of an unorthodox way to do this, but it works. So just pause for a second, make sure everything's lined up as it should be. Just double check that you've caught those edges. And then we're gonna press this really, really well. I'd probably recommend, if you haven't got a pressing mat, using steam at this point, because you really want to get this pressed well. So this is what the block will look like when you're finished. I think you'll agree, it's super cute. Maybe add on some sashing and then some binding. Maybe put it on a cushion with some lovely pom-pom trims perhaps. So I hope you've enjoyed, and I will see you next time for another lovely demonstration. Thanks for watching, bye.